Hello friends, today's topic of discussion is active transport. It is an important short note in university examination. Also, it is a part of LAQ, that is transport across the cell membrane. It is divided into, means transport across the cell membrane, it is divided into three main types, that is passive transport, active transport and vesicular transport. In active transport, three points are important. The first one is, it is against the concentration gradient, means from low concentration to high concentration. This is the first point. Second point is, it requires energy. There is direct or indirect utilization of energy. And third point is, it is carrier mediated. Carrier proteins are required for the transport. That's why it is known as active transport, means utilization of energy and from lower concentration to higher concentration. That's why it is known as active transport. Now there are two types of active transport, primary active transport and secondary active transport. Primary active transport means when the utilization of energy is direct, it is known as primary active transport. And when the utilization of energy is indirect, it is known as secondary active transport. The example of primary active transport is sodium potassium ATPase. It is also known as sodium potassium pump. Okay. In the sodium potassium pump, what is the mechanism of sodium potassium pump? It pumps out the intracellular sodium outside. Means three molecules of sodium moves outside against the two molecule of potassium which moves inside. So it is responsible for lowering the intracellular sodium level while increasing the intracellular potassium level. And here energy is utilized by hydrolysis of ATP molecule into ADP and inorganic phosphate. So here utilization of energy is direct. That's why it is known as primary active transport. Now look, this is the second example. This is the example of secondary active transport or SIMPOT. In secondary active transport, here along with the sodium, glucose moves inside the cell. Okay. And this, to pump out this sodium outside, there is sodium potassium pump which utilizes the energy. Okay. Energy is utilized here. So there is indirect utilization of energy. That's why it is secondary active transport. Here energy is utilized directly by the hydrolysis of ATP molecule. What are the examples of primary active transport? This is the first, that is sodium potassium pump. Second one is the calcium ATPase. Third one is the potassium hydrogen ATPase. Calcium ATPase, potassium hydrogen ATPase. Okay. Now in secondary transport or secondary active transport, there is utilization of energy by the indirect way. It is divided into three main types, that is uniport, simport and antiport. Uniport, simport and antiport. Uniport means when one molecule moves from lower concentration to higher concentration, it is known as uniport. Simport means when two molecules transported together, it is known as simport, or it is also known as co-transport. It is also known as co-transport. Means two molecules moves together. That's why it is known as simport or co-transport. For example, sodium glucose simporter. Example is sodium glucose simporter. Second example is sodium amino acid simporter. What is the significance of this simport? It is important in absorption of glucose from the intestine. It is important in absorption of glucose from the intestine. Also, it is important in absorption of amino acids from the intestinal cell, also from the proximal convoluted tubules. Okay, so it is important in absorption of glucose and amino acids from intestine and PCT, proximal convoluted tubules. So example of secondary active transport is symport, antiport. Symport example is sodium glucose symporter, sodium amino acid symport. Significance: absorption of glucose and amino acid from intestine and proximal convoluted tubules. Got it? And second example is antiport. Antiport means when the one molecule moves in one direction and other in opposite direction. It is known as counter transport. Also known as counter transport. Counter transport or antiport. Sodium moves inside while hydrogen moves outside. It is also known as sodium hydrogen exchanger. It is known as sodium hydrogen exchanger. Second example is calcium hydrogen exchanger. This is the first example, sodium hydrogen exchanger. Second example is calcium hydrogen exchanger. This is antiport. So it is important, sodium hydrogen exchanger, it is important in the renal tubular cell. It is responsible for maintenance of acid base balance. And this is calcium hydrogen exchanger, it is important in myocardium, and it is responsible for myocardium contractibility. So this is the significance of these two antiport system. What is the significance of this symporter? So sodium amino acid symporter, it is affected in cystinuria, where absorption of amino acid is defective. Cystinuria. And second one is Hartnup's disease. Hartnup's disease, which is related with absorption of tryptophan, where absorption of tryptophan is defective. So cystinuria and Hartnup's disease, this system, sodium amino acid symporter, is defective. Okay, and the drugs, one is that fluorazine. It is a drug which blocks the glucose symporter, sodium glucose symporter. This drug blocks this symport, and due to which there is decreased absorption of glucose from PCT, proximal convoluted tubule. Decreased absorption of glucose from proximal convoluted tubule, which leads to the increased excretion in urine. This is known as renal glycosuria. Summarizing the active transport, it requires energy. It is against the concentration gradient, means lower concentration to higher concentration. And it requires the protein, means it is carrier mediated. Two types, second, primary and secondary. Here utilization of energy is direct, here indirect utilization of energy. The example of primary transport is sodium potassium pump, calcium ATPase and potassium hydrogen ATPase. Example of secondary active transport is symport, antiport. Example of symport is sodium glucose symporter and sodium amino acid symporter. While example of antiport is sodium hydrogen exchanger and calcium hydrogen exchanger. Clinical significance: cystinuria, Hartnup's disease, then some drugs inhibit the absorption of glucose from proximal convoluted tubule. The application of this is, it is important in acid base balance, while calcium hydrogen exchanger, it is important in myocardium contractibility. So this is all about active transport. So keep watching. Thank you.